Hey, Uncle Mark and the Mothership, Three Strings, Cigar Box Guitar. Yeah. We are a 100% donation channel. We only exist because you are thoughtful and generous. We have PayPal and Square links down below. So definitely look in the show notes. There's tons of information in there. Just please look at that stuff. You know, it's kind of important for you and for me, and it helps me out. So this is Tuesday's Gone. This is Lynyrd Skynyrd. I'm going to do the little intro solo, and then the chords, and then we'll break it all down. So this is going to be a lot of information in a really small package. So here we go. That's kind of how I wanted to approach this lesson. So what I'm going to do first is break down the chords, then we'll look at the solo part, because it's basically that solo part all the way through the song with tiny bits of variation. So what do we got going on? G, D, G, 42, 34, 24. Those are my gauges. These are wound electric guitar strings. So G, G sharp A. A is the key of this song, and it's the second fret, and it's a bar chord. B flat B, C, C sharp, and D. We're going to use D in two positions. We're going to use the D up here on this seventh fret bar. We're also going to use this D that looks like 2-0-2. So it looks like this. And I really like this voicing down here, but I have to have this voicing up here to get this. So I use two different voicings. Voicings are just a musician's word for a different shape for the same chord. So if you're confused about that. So song is in A. It goes to E. And the way I'm going to use this E is 4-2-4. So I almost dropped my pick. What I want you to do is take your A, shift your elbow and your finger out, then come back with your elbow, third finger, pinky, this way. Then you're going to take that E and come up two frets, or a whole tone, to that F sharp. Then you're going to take this first finger, move it to the G, low G string, slide down to D. Then you're in position again to go to A. Then you come out with your elbow, grab that D string, and come back and make the E. And then you're going to slide all the way up to 7. And use that third finger on that E note. Slide back down to A. Train roll on. to on down the line. Okay? And then you slide up here to get this. Now, whether you go to this, my default D is here, or go up to 7, doesn't matter at all. It's totally up to you. I just try to avoid the jump, but I need this note. So I tend to come up that way. So in my first iteration, I go A, E, F sharp, D. And in my second iteration, I go A, E, D on the 7th fret, right? So that's how I like to play this. The Tuesday's Gone with the Wind chorus part is A. Tuesday, G, D, 202D, A, E. And then the 7th fret again, D. So we've got the chord structure basically in place. So we've got our initial chords for the lyrics, and we have our chords for the chorus. So let's look at that beginning sound on the organ where it's... Okay, so what you're doing is we're working around another way to play the A chord. Okay? So another way to play A is 9-7-6. Okay? So that is a perfect A. Has all the notes needed to make an A chord. So instead of that, we're going to take it away, and we're going to look at these two. See what I'm just working within this shape? So it's 6-7-6, D string 9, and it's just like this. So again, then you got to go from here down to that F sharp, because remember F sharp's in the chord F sharp, so we need that F sharp in there, and then it's back. Sometimes I default with my pinky doing this or this finger. And then there's a little trick right here, which is a hammer-on. So it's 6-7-9 and it ends up there on 7. And every time you do one of these, the only thing is that that ends up being that actual A chord. So you really need to be able to go from here or here to the A. So, feel a wind blow. So you really want to be able to shift your position from here to that A, and then you're back playing your chords again. So that's that. Now, the little jam section, okay? It requires bending. When you bend, I don't want you to think of just taking a finger and bending up, okay? It's really, really hard. So what I want you to do is take two fingers, take your elbow, and think this. This is the motion I want you to think in your mind. It's not exactly that, but I want you to think that. Anytime you bend, you want to bend to a place. So if I'm bending this note, I might want to bend to that note. So that's how I think. I'm always bending to a place. I'm not just bending, you know, and it can't be weak. This has to be a... It has to be a... That's the note you're looking for. And if you want to learn bending, try this note first. And you'll get up to here faster. This is what's called a whole tone bend. That's where I'm aiming. That's the note I'm aiming for. One bend. That's three bends to get that spot. So we're going to do one bend, land on the A. One bend, land on the E. Three bends, land on the F sharp. Then we move up, okay, to that A, and we need these two notes. These two notes here are really important. So let me start over. So that's where we are now. Then the part that got me the hardest, this is the hardest on this guitar to do, is the... So, these are notes in succession. 2, 4, slide to 6, 7, 2 on the D string, 4 on the D string, 2, and 4 again. So you got a lot of little hammer-ons in here, but you know, for the bend, if you're first starting out, I would try this C note and try to get that C sharp with it, right? And as you get better with bending, then try it on that B note and try to bend to the C sharp. You're aiming for here. Three times now. We're a 100% donation channel. We got donation links down below. Thank you so much. We have songbooks out, so check out that. Tess and I have put out a couple of songbooks. We're working on another one, so that's going to be coming soon. Just take a look at the links down below. Thank you so much for everything you do for me. I'm playing here through a Roland mini cube, and I'm on my basic clean tone here. I'm on the Brit combo. My gain is about a quarter. My tone is 3/4, and I've got a little bit of reverb. But other than that, this is a pretty clean song. It's a great tune if you just want to just play. Train roll on down the line. You don't need any of the other stuff. You can just play it as a great song. Do it at an open mic. Everyone will love it, and you really don't need the solo and stuff. But if you feel like doing that, I just wanted to give you that. And each little solo iteration is a tiny bit different, so play along with it, and it's really fun. Thank you so much for everything. Your generous support keeps this channel active. Thank you.